following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to our man Jim in Palm Harbor. Hey, what's going on, brother?
Hey, how you guys doing today?
Doing great, man. How you been?
Oh, great. I really appreciate you and Tommy. You do a great job, great work, and I really appreciate it. I watch you every day.
Well, thank you so much. We appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here, man. Let's go to Sylvia in Tampa. Hey, Sylvia, how you doing?
Hey, Tom. Good morning. Thank you so much for taking my call. I want to tell you thank you so much for the advice you gave me on dust yesterday. I exited when you told me, and I made a healthy profit for a very short period. So thank you.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Just making a great night, folks. Be impeccable with your word. Replace fear with love. The human mind is like a fertile ground where seeds are continually being planted. When you're impeccable with your word, your mind is no longer a fertile ground for the words that come from fear. Your mind is only fertile for the words that come from love. Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 194, NASDAQ up 78, S&P's up 24. Now, we look at these indices, folks, okay? My take on this, we're in an ABC, we're in the B to C of an ABC structure on the way down. And it looks to me that we just might have hit the B point. If we go take a look at these futures, what you're going to have, we'll start with the futures, okay? So if we pull this back so you can see this a little bit clearer, you get bottom line 3 days up in the marketplace. You know, we rejected lower price on Tuesday. You go a little higher Tuesday, higher Wednesday, higher today. That being said, what you're going to see out here is that we just came into just the futures are just shy of a 0.382 retracement. Now, we've gone to 28.94. 28.99 would have been the basically 0.618 retracement of the down move. If we go over to the SPY, what you're going to see, same type of setup in the SPY. And what we're going to have in the SPY is that, you know, we did volume yesterday of 73 million. You're at 48 right now. Bottom line, you can do about 75. 75 is coming into 144. And if we pull this back and take a look at this, it's the same type of setup. You're going to see, let's see, there's the 100 right there. So the SPY, the number on the SPY is 289.27. And we got to 289.21. So it looks to me like this is the number. This is where this thing can turn once again. What's going to be intriguing, of course, is that coming into Friday, you know, you could get a sideways move. But my take is that that is the B point of this ABC structure on the way down that we're looking at. Gold contract down $11.10 now. What you have with gold is this. We are coming down, and you have lighter volume into Monday. That being said, guess what? Bottom line, it doesn't look like gold's going to basically get any type of bounce today. So what that would set up is that would set up that's going to test that 1282 number tomorrow. And we got right next to it today, 1284. Notes and bonds, the note and bond market. Right now, you have the 10-year note pulling back with 1.2 million contracts. Now, that's going to be light volume because you'll see what you're coming into here. What the note and bond market are coming into is 1.9 million contracts. We're not going to do 600,000 contracts, 700,000 contracts in the next 60 minutes. So you are pulling back on the 10 with light volume. We get over to the 30. We take a look at the 30. 30 is going to be the same setup. 30 right now, contract volume has done anemic volume, 186,000 contracts. And that baby right here, now you're coming into what, 283, 283. So I suspect both of them still want higher price. And if we go to King Dollar does have the price going with it. It doesn't have the volume going with it. But the bottom line is that King Dollar does look like that it does want to get up and into the highs that were generated out here on the 26th of April. So if that's what we're going to get inside of King Dollar, we get up into that level, what you're going to end up seeing is that that gold contract will basically hammer that 1282 mark. Some of the higher volume equities out here in this market, and this will be a low volume market out here today. There we go. Okay, so we get Advanced Micro up 45 cents. You get Cisco Systems up 360. They came out with numbers last night. Uber's up $1.94, trading at 43.23. That is getting closer to its $45 IPO price. You get Qualcomm down $3.40. Marbell's up 48. We got Beyond Meat. That's up 5.42. That's trading $92. You get NVIDIA down 71 cents. If we go inside the Dow Industrials, taking a look at the strength versus the weakness out here. Strength, point-wise, you get Boeing putting 34 positive points, Cisco 24, Goldman 20, Microsoft 19. On the negative side, what we have out here is that you have 3M putting 17 negative points, Chevron putting 9, Caterpillar putting 3. Inside the NDX 100, strength versus the weakness inside the NDX. NetEase is up 6.8%, Cisco 6.8%, Workday 3.4%, Mercado Libre 3%. Taken away from it, it's the chip stocks. Xilinx is down 5.8%, you get Skyworks down 5.6%, Qualcomm's 4%, and Micron Tech is 2.8%. If we get over, take a look at that Xilinx. You're talking about something that was totally extended, way too far extended, then blows apart. Xilinx just went from $141 down to $107 in all of 3 weeks. The first gap down was from the earnings, but when you take a look at this on a longer basis, you're going to see this was a one-way route. It was a parabolic move. You know, we take this back, actually, you just take this back to July of last year. July of last year, it was at $64, and in April, it hit $141. And bang, right down, you're at 104 right now. Big numbers, man. No two ways about them. Micron Tech, we're going to take a look at Micron. We have with Micron out here. Micron is trading down $113. It's going to get interesting, man. This is hammering into a B point and just shy of volume. This looks like it's going to, this wants to do an ABC down. So you got Micron trading 37.29. Your B point out here has volume of 33 million. It's not going to go after it today. It's building cars to go after it. Then you get a high volume low that's laying out here at $28.39. As the high volume low in Apple. Apple also got that high volume low that's just sitting there, folks. Apple's setting up to make a run down to 142, and we're at 190. So you're talking about a monster number there. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Right back.
The TFNN Memorial Day Tiger Dollar Sale is here. From now through Memorial Day, you can get up to a 40% bonus on your Tiger Dollar purchase. Tiger Dollars never expire and can be used for any TFNN good or service. Whether you're a current subscriber looking to add instant savings, or you're a new listener or viewer that is considering signing up for any product in the near future, now is a great time to get your Tiger Dollars and lock in dramatic savings on all TFNN products and services. We only have a sale like this a couple times a year, so don't let it pass you by. Tiger Dollars are available in three purchase options with a 20%, 30%, and even 40% bonus. Once you purchase your Tiger Dollars, you'll be able to apply them to your TFNN account, and then they are automatically used for all your recurring subscriptions going forward, making it as easy as possible. For all the details on this Tiger Dollar promotion running through Memorial Day, visit the front page of TFNN.com and get your Tiger Dollars before this sale passes you by.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics, including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's up 196, Nasdaq's up 77, S&P's are up 23. Let's go over and take a look at the NQs, because the NQs, all the indices right now are coming down into where they were trading out right before they got a little bounce this morning. Let's put this a little bit closer. Okay, so there we go. So let's just take a look at this. So the number to keep your eye on here is going to be the 7590. And we need 6400. Yeah, this is going to be dangerous for this right now. So this is what's going on. Right when I got on the air, folks, okay, you had the first bigger sell, meaning 9,500 contracts, 10 minutes, right? This bar is just laying here right now, and what's going to happen, it's going to start a new bar before it actually gets to the low of the day, which is always dangerous. The reason that this is dangerous is that now you're going to have 10 minutes to bust that bar. And if that's what you get, more than likely what you're going to see here is 76. This is going to be pretty cool watching this thing shake out, because 76.41, yeah, you got $50, which could get you to 75.80 inside the queues. And come on, baby, where is that number? NQU9. 75.80. Oh, no, currency. That's not it. And it's Q. 75.80. It's weird. It's not coming up. Let me put the S&Ps up. ESM9. This thing is just slow right now. So if we do the same exercise here. Oh, this is interesting. This already broke. Okay, so check this out. This is pretty cool, actually. So the E-mini saying, now we get 94 down to 80. That's $14. 78, 74. No, it already went to 78. See, this is a small ABC down. That number, though, is 28.74. That's where it's saying it wants to go to. We're already at If you get to 74, you're going to get to 72, 2872. That's what it looks like it's going to be the number here as we come into the close. And if that's what you get, folks, that your probability does get higher that you're in an ABC structure on the way down. Because what's going to happen here is that we'll see whether it gives it up on price. And I know that doesn't sound like a lot of price to give it up on, but it actually is from where we were backing down and simultaneously if we get that light volume, which I suspect we're going to get. We take a look at some of the indices out here, the SMHs. That's been, you know, in tough shape for a bit of time. Just going sideways today. This is down $1.30. We go to the transports. We take a look at the transports. Transports got a pop out here this morning. So they're up $1.29. Let's go to the IYT because we can see the volume characteristic underneath that. Okay, so the IYT is 127,000 shares traded. You're going at the 600,000 though. Yeah, it's going to need a lot more than that for higher price. Exxon, Chevron, Exxon out here trading flat, down 3 cents actually. Chevron, and then what's interesting about this is that the XLE folks hasn't been able to get any traction whatsoever. You get Chevron down in a market that, you know, had basically a decent bounce here the last couple of days. You have 39 cents. And the XLE at $64.44, that baby's 6.9 million coming into 28 million. Yeah, not even close. We go take a look at, Cisco. Cisco came out with numbers last night. That is up $3.59. That has juice, man. That does have juice. So that can make a run for the high. Walmart also come out with numbers. Walmart had that spike high. And you're going to get another one. This Walmart, it looks like the last time they come out with numbers, it spiked all the way up to $104.18. We hit $103.96 today. You get 14 million shares versus 20. That little baby can get up into that level. The numbers on Walmart, they were large, man. Revenue, they came in with $123 billion. And bottom line, $1.13 there. I'd say that one of the biggest things inside there is that their digital sales are growing by 37%. That's you get a company like Walmart and you're growing digital sales by 37%. Their same store sales are growing by 3%. But that even 3%, when you see the size of Walmart, that's pretty incredible. There's no two ways about that. The XLU, the utility sector. Utilities today, look at this, it's not backing off. Now, this gets really intriguing, folks, because most times what you're going to have here, when you get a market that's higher, the utility will back off. And look at this, what this is saying, just like the bonds, this is saying that your probability is really high that this market, S&P, is going to be backing down once again. Because these utilities, they are strong. They're at their highs, by the way. This is what's really intriguing about this, okay? If we bring this back, what you're going to see is that this has been a one-way trip, you know, just as the long market has also. $24 up to $58.40. Bottom line is that you take a look at this Southern Company. That was one of the strongest ones out there, still out there, up 24 cents, trading $53.88. And this, look at that. That broke topside, had the juice behind the move. Let's go take a look at some of the home builders. Yeah, the numbers came out this morning. There were good numbers inside the building business. Toll Brothers got over its high of that 39.46. It's going to need more volume. We did 1 million versus 1.5 at that high. Lennar, we take a look at Lennar. Let's see what Lennar is doing. Lennar's up 99 cents. They're trading $53.91. Okay, need some more juice. It's coming right into the supply line. It's going to be interesting to see how this shakes out because Lennar has to take out this 50. Let's see. Yeah, $55.74. You take that out, and then that's a shot of going to the high. That's a fairly large supply line that is sitting with right there, though. There's no two ways about that. We got to take a look at a few others. Let's see. So you got Pulte. Who's the best performer out there so far? So you got Pulte's, it's up 9%. Meritage, oh yeah, so this is the largest one. NVR. You get NVR. Stock trades at, look at this, $3,347. And this, interesting, see, this is all-time high today. Now, what happens with this company, this has no legacy issues. That's what's also going on. You pull this back, what you're going to see is that bottom line, 2007, they didn't have a legacy issue happening. Their high is 37.70. They were at 33.43. Dow Industrials up 242. NASDAQ up 80. S&P's up 25. Come right back.
The TAS Profile Scanner is the most revolutionary piece of trading software that you will ever try. Wouldn't you like to approach the markets with confidence? As you begin your trading day, it's likely that you'll be faced with lots of decisions. In order to make the best decision, the first thing you'll need is a strategy that will help you minimize your risks. Whether we're in a bull or bear market, a good strategy is to have the tools needed to help you scan and analyze the markets before you trade. The TAS Profile Scanner instantly scans and filters over 2,500 global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, president of TAS Market Profile, the TAS Profile Scanner understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications, automated trading algorithms, and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. Whether you're looking at the trade matrix, the ETF heat grid, the market breadth, the landscape charts, or the many other features of the TAS Profile Scanner, this is a piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the markets and set up your trades. The team at TAS has even put together a 12-part video series to walk you through every aspect of the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find directly on the TAS order page at TFNN.com. Sign up now for only $97 a month with a risk-free 30-day trial so you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. See for yourself how you can harness the full power of the TAS Profile Scanner by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services section. Remember, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Don't let another day pass you by without trying out this amazing piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the market and how you place trades. Sign up today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the Bull Bear Nadex Options Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now up 225. You get the NASDAQ up 78. S&Ps are up 24. If we go over to Boeing, we take a look at Boeing. Boeing's got a little pop out here today. That is up $9.14. And that's all, that's all it is. This can get up to 365, though. You're 256, and what you normally get is this. So watch this. You got a break downtown, and now this is going back from the break downtown to test the break. And this is a classic Bud Rolfs channel coming right back. It's pretty cool how these work. So we'll see whether it can get through this 363. Right now you're at 354. Let's go to Al in Tampa. Hey, Al, what's going on?
Not much, Tom. How are you, Ben?
Good, man.
How's your family?
I'm doing great. And yourself?
I'm doing great.
Cool, man.
I've got a stock that I want you to look at, Dunkin' Donuts.
Okay, so I'm trying to figure out is. Let me see this. Dunkin' Donuts. Now, that got acquired, right? Oh, no, it's Dunkin' Brands now. That's right, that's right. It's Dunkin' Brands. Yeah, right? Yeah, I got it. Okay.
Yeah.
So, okay, so let's take a look at this. So the low for the year is 61, the high 77. We're trading 74.74. You love these food ones, don't you, man?
Well, no, I'm just looking. Every time I get one, I do all the work, and it usually gets bought out and stuff like that. It really pisses me off. I wish they wouldn't do that. I mean, Blue Buffalo and stuff like that.
Yeah.
I got into 7-Eleven a couple times. They've been bought out, and they brought bring them back. You know what I'm saying? They go private, and then they reissue them.
Oh, yeah. No, no. No doubt. No doubt.
I know. You do all the work, and they disappear.
Yeah, well, you can't have them forever. Let's take a look. So you got.
You could have Coke forever.
Yes, you can. 60. Let me just see where this is. See, this just did an ABC up. Let me see where it's at in it. So 60, and let's say just 37. So we get 23 there, which you get to 73. So what this did, Al, right, is that. So if we go back to. January of 2016.
Last year, yeah.
That, okay, so that leg there, that was an ABC up. See how it broke out the B point, right?
Yeah.
So that price projection, what I just said, it was 34. Let me do it again. So 60. Okay, so you got 24. Yeah, so that's. That's basically 74, 75, and we went to 77. So I suspect most times when that happens, right, you're going to have to build more cars. I mean, it's a good-looking stock, but you're going to have to build more cars to get higher because we just finished that off like 5 months ago. And you can see it's been going sideways for 5 months. Oh, and that, I see what it's trying to do, too. Okay, hold it. 1 second. I see what you're looking at, too. Yeah, I mean... Just keep a tight leash on it because, you know, if the market wants to go south, if this is basically if the S&Ps are an ABC structure on the way lower, you know, this...
It's going to take everything.
Well, it can take this down to somewhere like $70 pretty quickly. Do you know what I mean?
Right. Well, I get the question also, too, about Apple and Facebook. Do you think both of them might be going lower?
Apple, for sure. When I say for sure, I mean I think it's going lower for sure. Apple's sticking out like a sore thumb, man. That meaning that what you have out here is that the lows of the 3rd of January, that's a monster, man. It has 91 million shares. It's just sticking out there. What it did today, Apple tried to get into its gap. You got to a price point of 192.46. 192.77 was the top of the gap. Gave it up. Volume is contracting. That's technically. Fundamentally, they got a problem too, man. You know, fundamentally, bottom line is that, when you're in the phone business and you're announcing that you're not going to give out the phone sales, that kind of says it all. You know, you don't have to get much further than that, you know.
I got out at 205, so I feel pretty good.
Yeah, good, good.
You know, the second day of the downdraft,
okay.
I went ahead and... went ahead and got out of Facebook and also my big positions in Facebook and Apple.
Yeah.
That I had made the money in AM. Remember, I had made the AMD when it rode up.
Yes.
And rode the AMD up to like $32 from $10 that I my Roth and my IRA.
Sweet.
I'm not able to short, so I mean the only thing I can do is be neutral.
Right.
With cash.
Right. So, in Facebook's case, you know, I mean, it almost looks like it does want to test this 198 again. I mean, I don't see it making up into this the 218 area, but you know, it's the way it's basically out here.
Well, I'm waiting for them to say what the fines are, and that I figured that's going to be a big downdraft on it.
Yeah,
you know, all those.
There's no doubt, and I think what you're going to see though is that Facebook right now is basically operating like the banks are operating. I mean, you know, Facebook's going to take in $69 billion this year, $83 billion next year. They're just going to make that part of their overhead. It's the banks, you know, they get the fraudulent practices happening. They pay billions of dollars in fines. They just say, c'est la vie. No one ends up getting in the can. In Facebook's case, they keep saying they're going to fix privacy controls, but they don't. And I suspect they're going to keep paying up too. But just wait for a big downdraft, you know?
And I remember one thing you always said, that for the market to go higher, to really go good, the banks have to be involved in it.
Yeah, and if we take a look at the XLF, you get a little bounce out here as the market does, but the XLF hasn't moved much at all. I mean, you know, we take a look at this. Well, actually, no, it's right underneath its 07 highs, I guess. So it's been up there, but it doesn't look to me like it wants to break topside, because what you do have here, which hinders the banks, folks, is low interest rates. You know, right now the 10-year is at 2.398, and it doesn't look to me like rates are going higher at all. In fact, it looks like the Fed Fund future rate is saying that we're going to get a cut. Well, the probability of a cut, folks, went back over 50% in September. Well, look at this right now, 50.8. You know, you get one more down day, you'll see that go to 53 again. You know, these numbers move a lot, but if you happen to be watching Tiger TV, on that second column, that is the probability of a rate cut. And you can see the rate hike probability is zero, going all the way out to January of 2020. You know, so.
Fantastic, Tom.
Okay, brother.
I really appreciate everything you do for me.
Thanks so much, man.
And
you have a great one, a safe one. Dow right now is up at 223. You get the Nasdaq up 75. S&Ps are up by 23. And King Dollar. King Dollar's holding price up 304, 97.680. The euro's at 111. Yen is out here at 109.85. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the Tax Opportunity Zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN and you'll find the Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now. Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's up 185, Nasdaq's up 66, S&P's up 19. This is a nice setup, folks. This is the B to C of an ABC structure down. Now, what we have intraday is that you're doing ABC structure down and the Nasdaq as well as the S&P futures. We just broke the B point of this ABC structure down inside the NQ. So let's open this up so you can see how this shakes out. It's pretty cool. So you're at 75.89. Your A point up here is 76.41. Your B is all the way down here at the 75.90. It's going to get you somewhere to about the, well, here, I'll do the exact one as we do this. Let's just see this. So you get your A point up here, which is the high today, 76.41. And your B is down here trading at 14.10 at 2 o'clock this afternoon, which is the 75.90. And that gives you a 51.8 to B. Your C point is up there at 76.20, minus 76.20. Whoops. 75.69. All right. Yeah, 75.69. That's the number. We just broke the B. You just broke this in the last buy. Had some juice behind the move. And we'll see how that baby shakes out. You know, when we're talking about ABC structures, whether it's up or down, if you come over to our website, too, what you're going to see right under featured content, I'm Mr. Dave White. He just updated the time of the trade charts. We have a special that's going on until Memorial Day. If you hit time of the trade charts there, you're going to see you can get the Art of Time of the Trade charts for 1 month. You get 25% off, and the special, folks, is that you are going to get my book, The Art of Time and the Trade, absolutely free. So if you hit subscribe, when you hit subscribe, folks, we have a promo code. The promo code is book. You put book in there, add the code, and you're going to see it takes off $19.75 of your first month of Time and the Trade charts. As you're over there at the featured content, what you're also going to see is the Tiger Dollar sale. We do this a couple times a year, and it's hard to believe that it's already 6 months later, but guess what it is? The way Tiger Dollars work, they're good for any product at TFNN. If you get any subscriptions right now, it's a great way to save money. You can save either 20%, 30%, or 40%. You can buy 500, and you get 600 Tiger Dollars, which is a 20% savings or bonus. You can buy 1,000 and get a 30% bonus or a $300 bonus, get $1,300. You can buy $1,500 and get a $600 bonus or 40% of $2,100. So check it out on the front page of TFNN. ABC structures, it looks to me like they're going to be all over the place here. If we go over to the SPY and take a look at it, it's going to be really intriguing if it comes just a little bit lower, too, because what you're going to have there is that then you're going to basically have a rejection of the highs that were generated out here last Friday. That's how this is set up right now. That number there is 288.94. Yeah, we got over it. We got over that baby. You're not going to come close to the volume. That's 112 million. Right now, we've only done 55. It looks to me it's going to have a hard time actually doing the volume of yesterday. And that's what even brings your probability higher, that that's what this setup, this was Patton that is running out here, almost looks like. Inside the NQs, which bottom line had, was the strongest yesterday, not necessarily today. NQs also got over the high of last Friday. That number is 185.90. We got to 186.07. So that's going to be the same number. That's your benchmark. We are not going to do 58 million shares inside the Qs also. So price-wise, they're kind of right where they could actually close right here, and that would be a failure on price, failure on volume. That being said, I do think you're going to get just a little more pressure coming into this close. The reason being is that when we just did break that B point, you're going to see it was a good break. You know, if I just bring up the SPY right here and take a look at it, you're going to see that your first break was there. The first break was at 3 o'clock once I started. Yeah, the second break was only 10 minutes ago. The third break is right now, and the third break right here has some real juice in it. If you take a look at the SPY, you've already put 1.9 million shares into it. If we bring this all the way over, what you're going to see is that we are where we were at 9:50 a.m. this morning. So bottom line, it doesn't need much more coming down to get that full rejection of price going. If we go take a look at the small caps, IWM, that is a classic, man. You hit 156.17 and you're at 154.84. Volume anemic. I mean anemic. Look at this. 11 million shares right now, 11.2 million. You're going into 26 million. If we take a look at this, let's look at this intraday. Look at that. All the way back to the open. Open and bar out here is 154.51. You're at 154.82 right now. Yeah. You still get some major selling inside this marketplace. What we did do and we got yesterday is that, let's see how many more we got. We got the 13F filings. With 13F filings, folks, are the large funds, the mutual funds, equity funds, hedge funds, private equity, all of the above. They have to file their 13F when they're buying or selling these positions inside these companies. They're filed for the quarter. They come out public 45 days later, and that's what we have out here. And we got those out last night. And what you're going to see is that inside Amazon, Buffett finally came into Amazon. You're going to see him here somewhere. If I pop this in, the newest buys, there it is right there. So they own nothing. You don't know when they bought it. You know that in this particular case, they had to buy it between January and March 31st. That filing is as of March 31st. 483,000 shares. That's what they bought. That's how they came in. If we go look, let's just go look from January to, okay, so we can start. Looks like he's going to definitely be in a winning position. So we can start at $1,487. That's January 1st. And then we go to March 31st. March 31st. Yeah, he's definitely in a, well, there it is. March 31st. 1792. So he's definitely in a winning position. But you can see that's that right in there. That's where bottom line, he probably bought right there. Or he busted topside. Let's say that's where it broke topside on the 15th of March. Yeah. So a lot of other inside the, when we come back, we'll do a couple inside of that gold market. They had a couple of buyers inside the gold market. No heavy sellers, bottom line. Market-wise out here, let's go from the highs to the lows inside the Dow Industrials today. So the high of the Dow Industrials, we're down off $120 off this high. 25,957 was the high. We're 25,835. Come right back.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Dow is up 195, Nasdaq up 66, S&Ps are up 20. And we take a look at the volume out here, folks, as we come into the close. Volume on the NYSE is 511. Now, it's going to get interesting. It's going to bump up, but I expect what you're going to see out here is that the volume is going to contract once again. Yesterday, so on Tuesday, we did 809 million. Yesterday, we did 768. We'll see what we end up at today. Inside the NASDAQ composite, same type of setup. Inside the composite right now at 1.8. We did 1.997 yesterday. Composite almost looks like it could get to maybe 2 billion out here. Yeah, that can probably get to $2 billion. Price-wise in the composite, we get to 79.46, and 79.49 was the high out here on last Friday. The other indices, if we take a look at the NDX, I believe it got over it. Let's see. So the NDX number was 76.23. Yeah, we did, which in the case of, when you're trying to set up what a benchmark is, what a B to C of an ABC structure down is, it's useful doing that. Let me just see now inside the actual cash. I don't need the cash. Let's just see how this works. Yeah, did the same thing. So the NQs also just about got to the highs out here. So after the close out here, and man, this day is going so fast, it's wild. So NVDA, I believe NVIDIA is coming out, which is going to put more pressure on the chip stocks once again. Yeah, so, oh, interesting. They come out after the futures are closed, though. So that won't put pressure inside the NDX 100. NVIDIA looks to me like it's going to get down. It's 131. We're at 160 right now, by the way. But this is sticking out like a sore thumb at 131. That's on your daily. And, yeah, this has been a bad scene for NVIDIA. It's down from 292. You're at 160. Stay right there, folks. We're going to be coming back with some numbers for you. Dow Industrials right now up 204. NASDAQ up 71. S&P's up 22. Coming back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to The Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get the competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This is TFNN, the Tiger Financial News Network. TFNN, headline news update.
Welcome, folks. We have the Dow finished up 215, NASDAQ up 75, S&P's up 23. We look at the percentages out here, folks. You had the Dow Industrials up 0.8%, NASDAQ up 0.9%, S&P's up 0.7%. We go take a look at the SPY, what you're going to have here. It looks to me, folks, is that you get a classic B to C of an ABC structure on the way down. The SPY, we got to a price point today of 289.21. You did have a contraction of volume once again. Yesterday we did volume out here of 78 million. Today you're at 66. You go right up to a 0.618 retracement. Bottom line comes off that 289.21. and you finished out at 287. What that also did, by the way, is that it got over the high of last Friday, closed underneath it, and had tremendously lighter volume. You're talking about that was going into 112 million shares, bottom line with 66 million. Now, you had Harmony also in this indices, meaning that the Qs also got over the high of last Friday. We did 37 million versus 58 of that high. Also contracted with volume from yesterday, 40 million to 37. Pretty amazing, actually. It's pretty hard to do, too, by the way, folks. IWM, same setup. Different differential is IWM never made it to the high of last Friday. We made it to a 156.17. We're at 155.04. Bottom line, yesterday had volume out here of 18 million. You contracted to 13, and you're going into 26. So big numbers all around. Gold contract, what I expect we're going to see out here with gold, folks. Looks like gold is going to basically go after that 1282. It's always dangerous coming into a Friday when you are coming in and the dollar went higher and gold went lower. And what we did out here today is that gold is lower by $10.90. You've done 264,000 contracts. Now, we're coming into big contract volume as well. We're coming into 379,000 contracts. The problem is that on a Friday, that low is roundable. It's only $2 below where we were today at 1284. Stay right there, folks. Numbers coming out after the close. We got NVIDIA, which will keep rocking those SMHs. A recap out here. We had the Dow Industrials finish up 214. NASDAQ up 75. S&P's up 23. Come right back.
TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the Bull Bear Nadex Options Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the tax opportunity zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted.
don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Oh, look who we have.
It's a beautiful day. Get our man, Jim from Minneapolis. We gonna take it by storm?
Taking it by storm, baby.
I love that. That's a great saying, man. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, gentlemen. How you guys doing today?
Good, man. Yourself?
Oh, man. It's been the most incredible couple of days since when I called in on Friday, Litecoin busted out of that consolidation on the two-hour chart.
Okay.
And it just never looked back. It did a 100-point ABC up, and now it's very extended the way I look at it. But
yeah.
Holy, it went up to $420 last night.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. It's making a great night, folks. Memorial Day is right around the corner. Pretty wild. Beginning of summer. Official beginning of summer. Always do your best, but don't overdo. When you overdo, you deplete your body and you go against yourself, and it'll take longer to accomplish your goal. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We had the Dow Industrials up 214, NASDAQ up 75, S&P's up 23. Gold contract down $10.80, trading at $12.87 an ounce. Silver off 25 cents, $14.55 an ounce. Light sweet crude up $1.03. $63.05 a barrel. Notes and bonds. You get the 10-year note down 5 ticks, 124.16. 30-year bond down 11 at 149.17. And King Dollar. King Dollar up 279 ticks, trading 97.655. The euro is at 111.74 to 1 U.S. dollar. The yen is at 109.82. And the pound is at 127.93 to 1 U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. I want to go to the world of the bond markets first. Let's take a look at the 10-year. So we're done with the 10-year out here, folks, is that you are right next to the highs of March. We have done 100 or 1.3 million contracts out here today. This baby's building cars to get up and into the high of March, which is that 124.31 number. If we go over to the S&P, what you're looking at is this. My take is that it looks to me like your B point of an ABC structure down is set up here. And what I mean specifically is that an ABC structure down goes like this, folks, is that you come down with volume, you do a nice bounce with light volume, and then you go attack the lows once again. If we go take a look at the retracement value from the highs to the lows, what you're going to see inside the SPY is that we got right to the 0.618 retracement of the move lower. That number there, we got the 289.21 today. That number was a 289.18. Bottom line, it pulled back. We had volume yesterday of 73 million. You get volume today of 72. It's really hard to do that, folks. It's hard to. What happens is this: is that so? Picture it here, just so you can see this correlation, how this goes. When we came down off the highs, right? First, we made a high. Made a high out here on the May 1st, 71 million shares. Then we come off the high with 107 million. You come off the high with 144. We make the low up with 127. Then Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Monday, we do 77 million. Tuesday, you do 73.9 million. Today, you do 73 million on the button. NDX 100, same setup. We have harmony in the marketplace in the fact that they both, all three indices, actually had lighter volume, came into last Friday's high, couldn't handle last Friday's high. The Qs today, we went to 186.07. 185.89 was the number. Volume there was 58 million. We did 38. Volume yesterday was 40. We're at 38. Bottom line, failure on price, failure on volume at a 0.618. Small caps are the weakest. Small caps, IWM, did 13 million shares. You're going into 26. Now, the differential in the small caps is that what you had is that the small caps couldn't make the high of last Friday. That goes to show that it's weaker. And what ended up happening also is that the small caps basically gave up all the price power that it had out here today from the 9:30 a.m. start. 9:30 a.m. start, the stock, the opening bid was 154.51, and the low of the last buy was 154.63. So it's pretty wild. You got a little pop at the end, but it's pretty wild how that whole thing shook out. King Dollar. What do you have with King Dollar? Bottom line is it held price. You know, bottom line is that King Dollar looks like it is going to go after those highs again tomorrow. And that will put more pressure in the metal market, no doubt about that. King Dollar right now, we're 97.660 and 97.705 inside the continuous contract is the number that gets you up and over the whole consolidation once again. And right now in the continuous contract, we're trading 97.660. So it's 97.705. That was the high that was generated out here in December. Each time that we've got up there, gives it up in spades. Each time that it goes down, it only seems to go down for one day with any volume. Volume contracts, goes back higher, volume contracts again. The bulls and bears have been fighting over this level for quite some time. Some of the higher volume equities in this low volume market out here. We had Advanced Micro up 43 cents. You had Cisco Systems. They came out with numbers last night. That was up $3.49. Microsoft up 291. Qualcomm down to 345. Intel, that's down 9 cents. That's no big deal there. When we are coming back, we're going to come back. We're going to give you NVIDIA's numbers. NVIDIA closed at $160.19. The low for the year is 124. The high is 292. They are going to be coming out with their numbers at 420 this afternoon. They are going to be looking for a revenue number of $2.2 billion. They're going to be looking to take 81 cents to the bottom line. And the way that the NVIDIA is set up, folks, NVIDIA hasn't had a good last 7 months. NVIDIA has just gone from a price point of $292 last October. Right now, you're trading at 160. NVIDIA, basically, bottom line, looks to me like you're still going to be game somewhere into this, so 146 to 131 area. So this number is going to be intriguing, seeing where this whole baby shakes out, because it will affect the chips in general. What affected those chips in general today was the Weihua, the executive order in the IT market. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
The TFNN Memorial Day Tiger Dollar Sale is here.
From now through Memorial Day, you can get up to a 40% bonus on your Tiger Dollar purchase. Tiger Dollars never expire and can be used for any TFNN good or service. Whether you're a current subscriber looking to add instant savings, or you're a new listener or viewer that is considering signing up for any product in the near future, now is a great time to get your Tiger Dollars and lock in dramatic savings on all TFNN products and services. We only have a sale like this a couple times a year, so don't let it pass you by. Tiger Dollars are available in three purchase options with a 20%, 30%, and even 40% bonus. Once you purchase your Tiger Dollars, you'll be able to apply them to your TFNN account, and then they are automatically used for all your recurring subscriptions going forward, making it as easy as possible. For all the details on this Tiger Dollar promotion running through Memorial Day, visit the front page of TFNN.com and get your Tiger Dollars before this sale passes you by. No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go take a look at Pinterest. Okay, so Pinterest, I believe, just come out with numbers. This closed at $30.86. The low for the year is at $23. The high is $35. Now, this just went public, though. This went public at 19, I believe. Yeah, $19 went public on the 17th of April. This is trading right now at $26.42. So let's see what they have to say. Okay, so they had a loss of $42 million. They expected a loss of 38. Oh, no. The expected loss was $42 million. They lost 38. Revenue, they had expected $200 million. They made $201 million. So they made it on revenue. They see for the fiscal year, they had an estimate of revenue of $1.09 billion. Now they're seeing $1.06 to $1.08. So down slightly. And if we take a look at the equity after the close out here, you had it down, what, $3? $4. Yeah, $4. So you're down 12%. That being said, it was trading there yesterday, the day before yesterday. NVDA, let's go see if NVIDIA come out yet. NVIDIA closed at 160. That's trading at 160 still. Let's see if it popped yet. No, that didn't pop yet. That's going to be out any minute, though, because that is, they were coming out with their numbers at 420. That's what they announced anyway. We're going to take a look at the SMHs in general. What you had out here inside the NDX 100 today, folks, is that the chip stocks were the ones that were putting pressure downtown. You had Xilinx was down 7.2%. You had Skyworks down 6%. Qualcomm was up 4%. And ADI, Analog Devices, was down 2.9%. What that was all about is that you had the administration, the president put an executive order in last night about IT in general, and this is aimed at Huawei. These are all suppliers, and bottom line is that we'll see how this executive order is going to shake out, if in fact any of these larger companies are going to get basically some waivers. And I suspect they're going to, though, because you know what happens is that if you look at this is what's really wild, folks. So check this out. This article was in the, in the Wall Street Journal sometime in April. I can pull it up. I think it was April 20th, right around that week. And what it was about was that our defense suppliers, right? So, you know, we got this battle on, trade battle, TAF battle with China, okay? You get the IT battle with China on in a huge way, right? Because of the fact that who's going to control 5G. Well, that being said, if you go back and you actually take a look at this article, it's amazing the amount of loopholes that are, number one, not only in the article, but the amount of support and partnerships that our own defense contractors are actually doing with China. And inside this article, what it has is that it's illegal for our defense contractors to sell certain technologies to China or anywhere else that the Pentagon says you can't. What's not illegal, though, and this is what they're doing, right, and this is what the article's about, is that Boeing turns around, puts a satellite up, right? What ends up happening is that they rent space and they rent time to the Chinese for the exact same thing that they can't buy. So it's like, you know, you got these companies that basically will do business with anyone. But that's not my point kind of on this. My point on this is that, you know, you have all this battling going on. And all we hear about is, okay, you got the TAFs, you got the Huawei. When in fact, the administration, everyone else knows that, hey, there's a million other ways around this. But guess what? If their companies and our companies are making money on it, they let it slide. So it's pretty strange, man. I mean, you know, they're in bed with each other. That's the bottom line. And they're claiming that the whole world, you know, over the TAF issue is a huge problem. Well, there's probably a larger problem in the aspect of them renting when they're not supposed to, the government's saying they're not supposed to sell them. NVIDIA closed at 160. Evidently, they're making money. It's at 169. So let's see what NVIDIA has to say out here. NVIDIA revenue, the estimate was 2. Let's see. Where are we? Okay, estimate was $2.19 billion. They did $2.22 billion. Earnings per share, estimate was 81 cents. They did 88 cents. That's in the first quarter. Second quarter, what they see, the estimate had been $2.53 billion. They are going to do $2.55 billion plus or minus 2%. Gross margin is running at 59.5%. Big number, man. The CEO is the company of is saying that they are back on an upward trajectory. So let's go see NVDA. Let's go see where NVIDIA is when it's trading $10 higher. And, well, it's back where it was last Friday. See if this baby is going to hold. You know, for the last 2 weeks, NVIDIA is down from a price point of It was 193. And right now you're at 169, 170. Even 167. We're at 169. We're at 167. We'll see where this baby shakes out. My take is that the NVIDIA wants to make its way down into this lower range of that 131 area. So it's going to get intriguing watching this whole thing shake out. If we go over to Qualcomm, Qualcomm got hit today also, but Qualcomm still is laying at highs. It was down 345 here at $82.81. Qualcomm, of course, went topside when they won that court case in a huge way. Then they come out with numbers, big numbers also inside of Qualcomm. We take a look at the, what was Skyworks? SKWS. No, one second. There we go. SWKS. Okay, so Skyworks is down 476 today. And this is getting hit a couple different ways. Apple's getting hit, so this is getting hit. Yeah, this is in trouble. So you get an expansion of volume on the way down today. You're down off this price point of $120. You're at 73. Bottom of this range out here is $60. Yeah, right now you're at 73, and 60 is game at the bottom of this. Now, this has been a consolidation for a long period of time, but what a massive consolidation. The low was like $50 to $60, and the highs are $117. That is one huge consolidation. Market-wise, that's kind of, it looks like that we're actually in also, folks, a very large consolidation. Recap out here, we had the Dow up 214, NASDAQ was up 75, S&P's up 23. Come right back.
The TAS Profile Scanner is the most revolutionary piece of trading software that you will ever try. Wouldn't you like to approach the markets with confidence? As you begin your trading day, it's likely that you'll be faced with lots of decisions. In order to make the best decision, the first thing you'll need is a strategy that will help you minimize your risks. Whether we're in a bull or bear market, a good strategy is to have the tools needed to help you scan and analyze the markets before you trade. The TAS Profile Scanner instantly scans and filters over 2,500 global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, president of TAS Market Profile, the TAS Profile Scanner understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications, automated trading algorithms, and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. Whether you're looking at the trade matrix, the ETF heat grid, the market breadth, the landscape charts, or the many other features of the TAS Profile Scanner, this is a piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the markets and set up your trades. The team at TAS has even put together a 12-part video series to walk you through every aspect of the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find directly on the TAS order page at TFNN.com. Sign up now for only $97 a month with a risk-free 30-day trial so you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. See for yourself how you can harness the full power of the TAS Profile Scanner by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services section. Remember, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Don't let another day pass you by without trying out this amazing piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the market and how you place trades. Sign up today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the Bull Bear Nadex Options Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. After the closeout here, we had NVIDIA, NVDA come out with numbers. NVIDIA closed at 60. That's trading at 168 right now. And we get Pinterest. That also come out with numbers. That closed at $30.86. That's trading at $25. That's accelerating on the way down. So that's down 25. It's down $5 right now, 15%. This is an IPO that was successful, though. It came out at $19. I talk about another IPO that was successful. That's Beyond Meat. Beyond Meat right now closed at $92 out here today. Looks like an ABC structure up to 101. And UBER, we'll go to the two failed ones. Two failed ones out here. This month you had Uber. That was out of $45. Now it's at 43. So these folks inside Uber, they're getting closer. We hit 44.06 today. Lyft, L-Y-F-T, that's in a lot worse shape. No two ways about that. That's at $55.60. Now, this baby went IPO at 72, went up to 88, I believe, first day. Yeah, 88. That's still trading $55.60. That doesn't... Now, Lyft is a confirmed ABC structure on the way down to 41. We got to 147.17 on Monday. Bottom line, you know, it looks like you got a counter trend bounce up here. Can get to get to 57. When it broke the B point, it's 60 to 52. Broke the B point on the 8th of May. That's it went south. It went south in a big way, no doubt. We go take a look at, let's see, when's FedEx, FDX? So FedEx, they're not coming out with numbers until June. But what you have out here... You get it trading down. It was up $3 today. That's interesting. It's up $3, and you had was it Morgan Stanley? Someone came out and Morgan Stanley's coming out saying they may miss numbers, which can hurt their shares. We'll see. Deer is so that's 17th. Is that? Yeah, tomorrow morning. Oh, this one's going to be interesting. So this is the Deer company. They're coming out with numbers tomorrow morning. The low for the year is 128, the high is 169, you're trading at 145. They are going to be looking to take in revenue of, they're looking for a big quarter this time, $10.2 billion. So this is their, this is the quarter that they take in all the bread at. Interesting, man. It must be right before everything starts happening in the farming business. Yeah, $10.2 billion. They're looking for some big numbers, man. And they're looking for $3.62 to the bottom line. So this is right before, I guess, everything happens. Now, that being said, this doesn't look great, man. You know, you're down off this 169. You're at 145. This is probably, this is a monster consolidation also. Look at the size of this consolidation. Wow. So this has been in a consolidation since November of 2017. And put this on a monthly. Okay, so this is going to be something to watch because this is not bad. So picture this, folks. Now, when you have a consolidation, this is a large one also because the top's 175 and the bottom is 128. But watch this, okay? Because if they come out with numbers that are not great, you know, this can go to the bottom of the consolidation. But guess what? This is coming down. This just came down from that 167 area to where we are, and the volume's really light. You know, so I expect we're going to get to the bottom of it because, you know, you got a high volume buy that's sticking out. But this could be a setup for a buy because what you have is this. So you have a break topside going all the way back in November of 2017. Then that break topside went from 130 to 150. 2 months later, you're up at the highs of 175. You come all the way back the first time you try to test the breakout area, and the low of the breakout area is $130. Well, you made it to 131, and you had 67 million shares. Now, that's a lot of shares. So you bounced again, then you came back again with 61 million shares. So 61 million is going against 67. Now, watch what we're doing now, though. You've only done 25 million shares thus far. You'd love to see this get into it and try to test this month, because the way this is set up right now, your probability is really great that you're going to get a lot less than 61 million. And that would be the third test of the breakout area. And if you get a rejection, that's saying, okay, man. And what's so cool about that is that what I'd be hoping for is that it actually comes into that area and the news is terrible. Like, you don't want the news to be that, yeah, the TAFs are hurt and this is hurt and that's hurt. And that's what you kind of want inside of that. And that's what you got. And if you got down to that level and rejected it, that would be awesome, because then you get everything going with you, meaning that you have the news being bad, stock comes down, yet it has tremendously lighter volume, and it rejects lower price. That is the classic setup when markets actually want to go higher. They just spin right around. Sorry about that, folks. Just had something in my eye. Well, let's go take a look at Applied Materials. Applied Materials, they closed at $41.66. This is trading at $43.23. Get a small pop out here. Let's see what they have to say. The earnings, their estimate was 67 cents. They made 70. Net sales, $3.49 billion. They did $3.54 billion. And this is what we do want to see. Applied Materials, the biggest maker of machines used in the manufacture of semiconductors, gave a stronger than expected forecast for the current period, indicating that chip makers are betting the industry slowdown in demand will end soon. Applied Materials, let's see. Applied Materials projected their fiscal third quarter sales at $3.52 billion, the company said Thursday. That compares with analyst estimates of $3.53. What we want to see is that we want to see what the backlog is. This is what ends up happening for Applied Materials, folks, is that this is one of the first companies that when their backlog starts going higher, that's when you know that the chip makers are actually making money hand over fist. Because what happens is that it takes so long to make a semiconductor factory. And they don't have this right here. This will be in the numbers, though. This will be in the full numbers. All I have is a couple one-liners out here. Historically, chip equipment makers have had some of the most volatile earnings in the tech business. There's no doubt about that. Their machines, which cost tens of millions of dollars each, take months to make and even longer to install. So when the semiconductor company wants to cut costs quickly, the obvious option is to delay Applied Materials orders. And it's just the opposite on the way up. What ends up happening, and that's what they're talking about there actually, is that what is the backlog? As the backlog goes higher, guess what? Chips are going higher. Dow finished up 214, NASDAQ up 75, S&P's up 25. Come right back.
Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today.
An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Baidu.com. Let's go take a look at Baidu. Baidu closed at 153. That had been up $1.20 for the day. It's trading at down $13. Now, this is going to be a monster ABC down, folks. This has been stock in trouble anyway, but look at the size of this ABC. This you get, well, let's see. I'll do it the most conservative way. You got 174. Yeah, you get $25, $24. That brings you down to 127. And is it already there? One second. What did I just say that was? No, 140. Okay, so you get an ABC down to 127. Bring this back. Put this on a weekly. Ooh, it's even a bigger one. Look at this. Hold it. One second. A weekly. This is a disaster. 234. Look at this. You get an 80-point A to B. That gives you 106. Okay, let's go find 106. What's that right there? One, that's it. Yep, look at this, man. This is a decisive break downtown. And then you get a, this is pretty wild, actually. Wow. Yeah, you know, it's so weird, folks. We have 106 for the this ABC structure down, but you get a spike down for some reason in 2015. That within 1 month, it went from 179 to 100 and then closed out at 147. Let's see what they have to say. So, first off, Baidu search engine, like Google, that's what it is. Company office, search, news, images, voice assistants, all of the above. And this is what they have to say out here. So, their first quarter, the estimate had been 24.271. They did 24.1. That's in billion, 24.2 billion won. They did 24.1. Earnings per share, let's see, profit per AD. Profit per ads. I don't know why they're doing that. I don't know. Adjusted profit, they were looking for a loss of 1.47 billion won. They had a profit of 401 million won. The market's not believing that. You can see that pretty clearly. They're on the second quarter, they're projecting, the estimate had been 29.32 won. Now they're looking to do 25. Well, that's where they're getting smoked, too. Okay. So for the quarter we're in right now, they were looking to do 29.321. And the won right now is almost 7-1 to 1 U.S. dollar, folks. If you want to, it's 6.9 or something to 1 U.S. dollar. Just count 7. It's easier to do. So then their revenue, what they're expecting is 25.1 to 26.6. And then what they are going to do is that they're going to do a 1 billion share buyback. Let's see. So the leading Chinese internet search provider today announced that the board of directors authorized a new share repurchase program, which the company may repurchase up to U.S. 1 billion of its shares effective until July 1st of 2020. So the 1 billion ends up being 7 billion won. And if we just go back into this again for a second and take a look at it, let me just see the, I'm just curious as to what the offshore one is trading at right now. 6.9 probably, yeah, 6.92. So the bottom line is that you are out there basically 7-1. That's quite a miss. I mean, that's quite a big number. There's no two ways about that. That is going to blow through all the lows. Whoops, one second. That's blowing through all the lows that have been out here this year. No two ways about that. We go take a look at the. Let's see if that's hitting any of the. I don't see. I know J. Okay. Let me pull this back. NDX. Because you know who that will hit? NDX. We take a look. No, let me. A couple of these other, is it China, JCOM? Is it? Nope, that's not. I'll move on. What I was looking for is that other Chinese stock that moves quite a bit. Up and down. That's in the internet business over there. That's what I was actually looking at. Some of the higher volume equities out here. Well, after the close, let's go just look at AMAT once again. So AMAT come out with numbers. Bottom line, closed at 41, trading at 43. Pinterest come out with numbers. Now that's getting hit. That had closed at $30.86. That's trading $25.96. NVIDIA also come out with numbers. NVIDIA closed at 160. That's trading at 171. So you get a few of those that are up pretty good after close. No two ways about that. We go take a look at the inside the financials out here. They just couldn't get enough traction out here today. The financials, what they did, XLF was up 27 cents, trading $27.06. Let's go take a look at Berkshire Hathaway, because Berkshire is the largest weighting structure inside of the financials, and that didn't hold price. So Berkshire, this is going to be interesting, man. Berkshire looks to me like it wants to get down to 186, and right now you're at 204. What's intriguing with Berkshire, of course, is that the position that they have in Apple, that is a monster position. And, at this particular point, I don't think that position, is in bad shape, because, Apple's high is, 233, we're at 190. But guess what? This goes back down to this 142 area, a whole different animal, because that would be bringing it all the way back to June of 2017, And when you take a look at the position, even for a Berkshire Hathaway, this is quite a positioning. As of the 31st, you still had them owning 5.55% of Apple, 255 million shares. That is a monster hold. Now, we did, is that, and this is important to understand, Fidelity now, these 13F folks, Fidelity is a seller of Apple. You know, Fidelity sold 9% of their position at the last filing. So I wouldn't put it by Fidelity that they're going to keep selling. In fact, you know what we're going to do? I'm going to find, let me just see if we can, I want to see if Mass Mutual and State Street are in here too. Because what tends to happen is that they all tend, if they're in the equities together, they seem to sell them together too. As I'm bringing this down, they're not very, so they wouldn't be that large owners, no, because they're not sticking out like a sore thumb, no doubt. And what Warren Buffett did do in the last filing also, he came in and they bought about 435,000 shares of Amazon. That position isn't a winning position because between January and March, and that's higher than it was in January and March. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that we'll even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. And folks, don't forget, when you go over to TFNN, we just have launched the Tiger Dollar program. We do this a couple times a year. Bottom line is that 6 months later already, this is the Memorial Day program. The way the Tiger Dollar sale works is this, is that Tiger Dollars are good for any product at TFNN, totally transferable, no expiration date. This promotion here, you can get a 20%, 30%, or 40% bonus of what you buy. If you buy $500, you get $600, which is a $100 bonus, or 20%. If you buy $1,000, you get $1,300 Tiger Dollars to spend, or a 30% bonus. If you buy $1,500, which is the max, you get $2,100, or $600 bonus, which is a 40% bonus on your money. If you have any subscriptions right now at TFNN, great way to save money ASAP. If you're looking for any in the future, great way to do it. Market-wise out here, what I suspect we have out here, folks, is that you get the B point or an ABC structure on the way down. Bottom line, it doesn't have to give it up tomorrow. But I suspect, I don't expect higher price tomorrow, I can tell you that. You might get some sideways move. This looks to me, we did get the contraction of volume once again. You get over the highs of last Friday. You closed underneath them. Dramatically lighter volume, 76 million versus 112 inside the SPY, inside the Qs. That went right along with it. Also, inside the Qs, you did 38 million versus 58. And then the small caps once again are the weakest indices. Once again, small caps really gave it up. We got to 156.17. You closed at 155 in the IWM. And the differential is that the small caps could not make it over the highs of last week. There just wasn't enough buying there to get up over those highs. So what I expect we're going to see is that we're going to see more weakness quicker in the small caps than in the S&P as well as the NASDAQ 100. We're going to be a lot more numbers that are going to be coming out in here in the morning. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Have a great night, safe night. We look forward to speaking to you right back here tomorrow morning, 9 o'clock. Go get them, folks.